that great redemptive plan that he had in his mind. So when it was going on, right in front of the devil's eyes, he couldn't recognize it because this one was just a piece. Right? I think I explained or mentioned last week that I know of people that have worked on machining parts. And but they didn't know there were machining parts for the U.S. rockets and for their fighter planes and stuff like that. Because they will give one part to one factory over here, that's all they're making. And they have no idea where that part is going or what it's going to do. And they have dozens and dozens of factories doing each part perfectly. It has to be done with precision. And then when it's done, then it is shipped to a central location, and then it's all put together. But nobody knows what actually they're doing. So that's the way it was with the prophets. Each one came and did his part. Each one lived out the word for his or her day. And in doing so, they were counted faithful, as if they were at the end and saw the whole thing. Because they did their part, right? And then God gave some of them a preview of what was going, the things that were going to be, right? So it was, what a wonderful plan. And it came right all the way down from Adam and right through Enoch and Noah, all the patriarchs, Abraham, right on down. And then the prophets, amen, praise God. There were some of them were literally acting out parts of what was going to happen. Some of them were allowed to even voice what was going to happen in part, right? Oh, like what meant David saying, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? When he was kicked out of his kingdom and Saul was hunting his life. It's just like Jesus coming towards and the devil's after him and tempting him and everything else. And then he goes to the cross and then what he says, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Brother Grant said, you see, that was Christ in David. And he was showing already what was going to happen.
Amen.
But he, at that point, he was in David.
Amen.
And so he was in the patriarchs, he was in the prophets. Amen. First, of course, he was in nature, right? Showing himself in the stars. And then he was in the patriarchs, and he was in the prophets. All the time, God condescending.
Amen.
Amen. What a wonderful plan that we had. So when the devil would see one prophet over here, one patriarch over there, another patriarch over there, the pieces of that jigsaw puzzle, each one was so separate that he did not know where the pieces fit. But God is his own interpreter.
Amen.
He will make it plain.
Amen.
He is the author of the book. And he knows where every piece fits.
Amen.
Amen.
Just like right now in his kingdom, we all have a part to play.
Amen.
And you just play your part the way you know it, live your life the best you know it.
Amen.
But the overall picture, God has a plan.
Amen.
And as weird or as wonderful as you may think your life is, you might not think you fit here or you fit over there or you don't fit there, God knows where you fit.
Amen.
He knows exactly why he made you the way he made you.
Amen.
Amen. Some are made straight, some made this way, some made that way, all of which, you know, twisted, you know, another way, part of their life got a little twisted up here or there ever, but God knows where it fits.
Amen.
So rest yourself in his grace and let him have his way in your heart and in your life. And at the end, everything will be made clear.
Amen.
Like Paul said, then shall we know as we are known. We want to know. Right now, even our knowledge is partial. Everything is partial. You only have five senses, and your five senses are limited. How much can you take? By the grace of God, right now Revelation is just glimpses and previews of eternity and eternal being that we're serving. He's just giving you glimpses of behind the veil so you can recognize who you are, who he is, where you come from, where you're going to, your path of life, the reason for things that have gone on that you could not. You ask yourself answers to questions that you don't know the answers, but all at once God starts making the thing clear.
Amen.
No matter how twisted you, this might have happened, that might have happened, that might have happened, but now is the time.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit brings the word together.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Coming from the east, the west, the north, the south. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God is the one that's working and bringing this together for his glory.
Amen.
With your voices in the Spirit of God, when the redeemed are gathering in, washed like the snow and free from all sin.
Amen.
How we will shout, how we will sing.
Amen.
When the redeemed are gathering in, we're singing now.
Thank you, Lord.
They're gathering in.
Yes.
From the east, the west, the north, the south, God is gathering his redeemed in. And we're so thankful to see that he's doing it supernaturally.
Amen.
It's not by the advertising of the evangelist. It's not by the marketing of the administrator. It's none of those things. Those are wonderful things, and we utilize every tool we can for the glory of God. But at the bottom of it all, it's the move of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's God moving.
Amen.
Praise his wonderful name. And we are thankful for that. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Oh, my. So we are so happy. The devil is out there and he's wondering to know what's going on. He's puzzled. He doesn't know what's going on. He knows that the rapture is the... But what is... How can he disrupt the thing? What can he do? He doesn't know where to start because God had it in a jigsaw puzzle.
Amen.
And it was so planned that he said, unto you is given to know the mystery of the kingdom.
Amen.
But unto them it's not given.
No.
Hallelujah. So after a while, as he begins to break the word to you, you start to see where the pieces fit. And then the Holy Spirit showing you where the pieces fit, your life starts to come to a resting place.
Amen.
You start to become, as Paul said, established. You start to become grounded. Why are people so tossed about? Because of the first part of your life, you're tossed about. You're trying to find yourself. You're trying to find your identity. And you're tossed about by the storms of life. But what happened, Brother Branham said, the real oak tree, when the storm comes, the other trees, a lot of them busted, broken, and everything else like that. Or the palm tree, is that right? You've been in the West Indies, you see those coconut palms, and you see those hurricanes going through there. And when the other trees are busting up and breaking and falling on the ground, most of the time, all the coconut palm tree will do is bend, humble itself.
Amen.
It can actually bend from being straight up like this to going almost to the ground. And when the storm passes, go right back. All the others, because they're not willing to bend, they're not willing to receive the word, they're not willing to change their life, they're not willing to, the righteous shall be as a palm tree.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Amen. Hallelujah. Glory.
Yes, sir. So we look into God's word and see how God planned this. Amen. And now that we recognize we are a part of this plan, and the plan is now coming to a culmination. It's starting to wind up. And anybody knows the excitement of being on a long journey from heaven, come down on the earth and have to go through all kinds of trials and tribulations. And then when you look, you see your home in sight.
Amen.
Somehow, unconsciously, you don't even have to think about it. Your footsteps start to quicken.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Your footsteps start to quicken. Your heart start to beat quiet. You see the lights of home.
Amen.
Praise God. That's the hour that they're living in. This is the season. And this is the time. Praise God. Oh, how do you think I can even speak this way? How do you think I can even talk this way? You think it's study? You think it's just because I, I, have you memorized? I have a good memory to memorize. No. I'm the least of who would think that way, brother, sister. I tell you the truth. I'm not saying that to some God, but I'm telling you the truth. Amen. But the fact is, brother, sister, this is the hour.
Amen.
This is the time. And God is the one doing his own work through us.
Amen. Amen.
We just got to let go and let God have his man surrender our lives. He's the one. He's taking over now. He's taking his governorship.
Amen.
He's taking his preeminence. He's taking his place as husband, as leader. Amen.
Amen.
Lion of the tribe of Judah.
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah. I would be surprised, like I said before, you in services like these and all of a sudden things begin to break out.
Amen.
Amen. With no human effort. No effort. Amen. Not trying to build up anything, but we are through. But the fact is, brother, sister, he will start doing it himself.
Amen.
You walk in the service, you're healed.
Amen.
You come in there with a problem and you get your answer either from somebody's spell, the word of pulpit, a hymn that was sung, some kind of thing, I don't know, I can't explain it, but you are going to receive what you're looking for. You're going to know for certain that that was God.
Yeah.
You're going to know that was God speaking to you, revealing himself, making himself known.
Hallelujah.
Thank God we don't serve, Brother Ben said, such a perfect man, we don't serve an idol on the wall,
yeah,
but we serve a living God.
Amen.
Praise God, a living God, and God is a spirit.
Amen.
And because he's a spirit, he needs hands and feet and voices and bodies. And we happen, or you happen to be those that were predestinated.
Amen.
From before the foundations of the world.
Amen.
From this hour.
Yes, Lord.
You are the people. This is the place. This is the time. And this is the hour. First step to the people.
Hallelujah.
They're coming unto us to fulfill the rest of the word that's left to be fulfilled. To fulfill all righteousness. I'm glad I'm a part of that jigsaw puzzle. I don't, you know, you may look at me, I may look at you, and maybe I think your form, shape, I'm not talking about your physical, I'm talking about your character, personality, and everything. You might be a little something here, a little something there, and yes, it may be there indeed. Right? But you know what Brother Bradman said? He said when Balaam, that make-believer, he was supposedly calling himself a believer too, but when he looked, all he could say, look, Israel, they commit fornication. Look at Israel. They were dancing and paganizing while Moses was up on the mountain. He could accuse them of all that. And Brother Bradman said, he was right. But what he overlooked, that God had already put the blood there to cover that present, that mistake, everything. God wasn't seeing that. He was seeing the end. He was seeing the end.
When
everything is done and all of it, he sees them perfect.
Hallelujah. Amen. Glory.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Oh my, let me read the scripture lest you think of not traditional preacher. Well, first, we go to Colossians back to read just a portion there. Giving thanks, chapter 1, verse 12. Giving thanks unto the Father which hath made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints. I'm a partaker of the inheritance of the saints. Amen. Who hath delivered us from the power of darkness and hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have redemption through his Holy Spirit, even the forgiveness of sins, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. Let's go right down to verse 18. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have preeminence. For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell. By now you should have a lot of understanding about that fullness. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm so happy, brother, sister, quoting Brother Brown here. Brother Brown said, I ain't going to even pay no attention to what any clock says. Sorry to start out this way. That's the quote. It's right here for Christ of the Mystery. I ain't going to even pay attention to what the clock says. I want you to get this. I don't care. See? So you can see here, basically, in the beginning, that the very thought that God had in his mind, he hid it from all of those scholars. And that's just a number, a pre-selected and predestinated number, predestinated people who was the only one that heard. Did you catch that?
Amen.
Basically, the very thought God had in his mind, he hid it. He hid his thoughts from all his scholars. And that just a number, a selected, predestinated number of predestinated people was the only one that heard. Praise God. Aren't you happy?
Amen.
And you seem it here to hear the voice of God. But of course, you can hear with your ears. But that's not the hearing the Bible is talking about. It's talking about hearing with your heart. Right? Because you can hear with words because of education and stuff like that. You can understand what I'm saying. But you got to hear with your heart. Amen. Praise God. Now we know that every single scripture expresses the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Every scripture expresses it. Any one word you can take and it will express Christ. Amen. Like we illustrated last week, but. You can even use but. But God. But the church prayed. But so and so happened. And you can line it up from Genesis to Revelation. Any one word in that Bible expresses Christ. And Brother Brennan said, when you caught the revelation, if you can't see Christ from beyond the foundation, right through Genesis, right to Revelation and beyond, he says, go back and check your revelation. Check your revelation. Because once you get the first genuine revelation, it begins to open up. Is that right? To you, I mean. The book is already open, but then it begins to open the book to you. There's a lot of people say, oh, the seven seals is open. Yeah, but is it open to you? So now we see that you may not know intellectually everything about it yet in your mind or in your head. But the book is open, and once you've caught the first revelation, the book is opening and unfolding to you.
Amen.
Is that right?
Yes.
So you don't need to worry, oh, I don't know this, oh, I don't have that revelation. No, you don't need to worry about that. That's God's hand.
Amen.
He'll make known what he needs to make known at the time, in his time, in his season. He does it in his time and in his season for his glory. Not when we push and shove and try to study our way inside of it to climb through the window rather than walking through the door and everything else. No, that's not the way it's going to be. That's the way it is. He takes his word and he reveals it in his time when he knows you need to do it. Is that right?
Yes.
Now we all know that a young woman committing an immoral act or committing a physical act before the time of marriage is called fornication. It's in the Bible. You're not supposed to do that. But also, we find out that a preacher, a minister, a believer, trying to force or to give you certain parts of the words that's too deep for you. One night, like I said to these other believers, the Holy Spirit said, if you do that, you'll be fornicating the word. Right? You're trying to push it to the person, but I'm not ready to reveal it yet. Don't do that. Let the Holy Spirit have his own way.
Amen.
And in his time, praise the Lord, just enough for people to hear, know, get a thirst, to receive more of the word, and then let God go to work. Yeah. Of course, you're going to pray, or one plant, the next one water, you know, and so on. You pray, and you believe, and you encourage, and then let God have his way, and people make their own decision.
Yeah.
Is that right? Yeah. Praise the Lord. We're not here, like I said, to lasso and brand cows. Is that right? We're not here to lasso people to make them into members. And that's not what this is about. It's so beautiful now that it's not my work, it's his work.
Amen.
Praise God. But in the early days, we didn't know any better. So we slinging out those quotes like David in a slingshot. Faster than David could get up to Goliath's forehead, we were getting those rock revelations out. My goodness, we want to stone the people to death, not realizing that exactly what we were doing. And not just giving them a chance to really come to an understanding so they can repent, confess, and come to the Lord.
Amen.
Is that right? Praise God. But I'm glad my eyes are open. And that I can see the word for the day and for the hour. Now, we understand that that's one of the reasons, and God bless you, brother. You were breaking into my message last night when we were just sitting chatting there, and all of a sudden, he said, you know, somebody was talking to me and telling me about the book of Maccabees and telling me about this book and this other book over there and so on, and that man wrote the Bible, and they decided to leave out the this and that the other. And I said, praise God. I said, brother, it's so nice that you're talking to me here, because that's not really the case, right? There were certain books written by men that were not included in the Holy Scriptures, and the Roman Catholics take it, and they add it to their Douay Bible, right? And that is the actual name, the Douay version. I usually say Douay anyway. But the fact is, brother, sister, they added a lot of books into their Bible that was not authenticated by Jesus Christ himself, by many of the prophets, whomever he spoke about them, whatever. You see, Jesus is the author of the book. As I've said before, when he came, it's almost like he was authenticating to us what to read, what to eat, what's scriptural, what is the word, what's inspired, right? I mentioned that, look, first five books of the Bible, he said, well, did Moses say? He just authenticated the Jewish Torah, which is the first five books in the Bible, because he quoted from them. Then he'll say, well, did Abraham say the prophets, the patriarchs? He's authenticating the books where the patriarchs wrote. Then you'll say, well, did Isaiah, well, did Jeremiah, well, did this one say of me, right? He's authenticating the prophets.
Amen.
Amen. And then let's not talk about the New Testament. They don't even question that, because they know it actually happened. That there was a person named Jesus in Israel, and he used that body for a while, and then died, resurrected, and went back to glory. And Paul, amen, praise God. All they can say, oh, Paul was a woman hater. But none of them question the fact that Paul wrote those books and that they're inspired by the living God. Now, not the Pope, nobody questions that. They know that it's inspired. So we know our entire Bible is inspired. But the reason why these other so-called books were not included, of course it was God's choice to include or not to include, but most of them, because they had no revelation.
Right?
They had no understanding when they wrote the book. Amen. Right? Second book of Daniel. Syriac. Book of Judith. I don't know who she is. Saint Judith. And this one and that one. Yeah, I don't know. But I won't go through all that stuff. I'm just mentioning it to show you. And I've read them, so I'm not only saying it, I've read them to know that it's just a whole lot of history and a lot of nonsense, and they have a few nice sayings, which is a copy from what was already said anyway, and stuff like that, and absolutely has no place within the boundaries of the Holy Writ.
Amen.
I'm saying this not for my sake, I know it already, but I'm saying it for your sake.
Amen.
So that those of you who don't know will know. Because you may be confronted with things like that. Say, oh, King James wrote the Bible. King James was inspired to encourage men to gather the known books and put them together. But he had to be inspired himself. That God, I don't mean he had to be a Christian or he had to be a religious man, but God moves kings and governors and people to do things when he wants them to do. Right? So that's the reason we have the King James Version of the Bible. And of course the devil comes after when he's trying to confuse the issue by giving you maybe 300 different so-called versions of other versions. Right? And they may be nice, they may be beautiful, and I will even use a quote from some of them, but that's not the real thing. The real thing is the King James Version.
Amen.
And the prophet came, and when he came, what did he use? The King James Version.
Amen.
And he said, you know, that's the Bible that I would use, the King James Version.
Amen.
And look, there, you know, if you go to the bookstores now, they're trying to get rid of that. You can hardly find the genuine King James Version. They put them in a corner somewhere, just a few over there. And all this one is New King James. NIV, CIV, CLT, this, that, you know, the Message. Even someone to trick some of you. They have a Bible called the Message. And so on. They have all these versions, but all it is to take you away from the original word.
Amen.
Because if you read those things, I didn't intend to spend time on this, but if you read those things, some of them are beautiful, but then all of a sudden there's one verse, and that verse is totally off. Because the person who was doing the translating didn't have Revelation. Right? It doesn't mean that the whole book is junk, but it means they didn't have Revelation. Now, I may be able to read it and see what they're saying and where they've been off, and just continue on. You may not. So I'm saying, keep your eyes on the King James Version.
Amen.
I'm advertising for the King James Version.
Amen.
Right? Praise God. And stay right there and keep your thoughts. Hallelujah. Amen. And one more thought along the line of what I'm saying now. They are not, were not included in the scriptures because they did not express God. They had no revelation, so they couldn't express God. They're expressing their own thoughts. Religious as they may be, and their own opinions, but they were not expressing God. So they're not in the scriptures. Praise God. Hallelujah. Now, listen, Brother Bradley quoting here. That's why people has added all those and got their jigsaw puzzle all mixed up. Right? See? They can't make the thing right that way. They can't make it the same yesterday, today, and forever. But if that thing gets put back together right, then the people, there's the entire picture of the fall right straight to the regeneration. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. What is he saying? When you get the revelation of the word, you start being able to see the big picture. You start seeing the whole picture. Amen. It's a little piece here, a little piece there, a little piece there. You start seeing the entire whole picture for the glory of God. Amen.
Amen.
Because the Bible, the entire Bible, is the love story of redemption.
Amen.
The whole Bible tells the story of man's fall right to his redemption, back up into glory.
Amen.
That's a beautiful story. That we, the greatest story that was ever told and will ever be told. Hallelujah. That's what this is all about. Glory to God. The whole picture of creation and God's whole plan revealed in Jesus Christ, and he is the Word.
Amen.
God's plan is revealed in Jesus Christ, and he is the Word. Thank Amen. God for that. Amen. Yes, sir. Glory to God. So here it is. I'm a Christian. Persons, I'm a believer. I believe the message, you know. They say, I believe the prophet. Brother Brandon was a prophet, but we know that that's not the message. Praise God. Hallelujah. That's not the message at all. The message is locked into the seven seals. Right? Notice, quoting Brother Branham, 564 of the seven seals, Notice, for the end of time message, this seventh seal, he called the seventh seal the message for the end of time. He said, this end of time message, this seventh seal, amen, there's the message, there is the seventh seal, hallelujah, this end time message, and that will absolutely be a total secret. He's preaching it openly, but yet it's a secret, amen, because they can hear it, but only the predestinated can be able to receive it, and that ought to give you blessed assurance.
Amen.
Because by your hearing, understanding, and receiving it, it identifies you. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. John the Christian, I'm a Christian. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm a Methodist. I'm a this. I'm a that. Whatever. Well, listen to Brother Bellum. You say I'm a Pentecostal. That don't mean that to God. It's Christ himself identifying in you. Hallelujah. As Christ identifies in you, that's when he has recognized you.
Amen.
Not you recognizing God, but God recognizing you.
Amen.
Is that right? Abel offered a better sacrifice, God testifying of his gift. Yes, I place the top there. Yes, I place the G over here. Amen. It's God identifying you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, praise God. I identify you that you are one of his thoughts that he taught all from before the foundations of the world. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because if God looks at you and he doesn't identify himself in you, amen, that he's the man in the mirror. When he looks, he sees himself in you. And then he recognizes you.
Amen.
Because he knows that you are one of his own.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. So it isn't what I'm claiming. It isn't what you're claiming. It isn't what anybody is claiming. It's what God is identifying and confirming and vindicating by his Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Glory to God. That's where it is now. That's real Christianity that we're talking about. Hey, brother, sister. Look, Brother Brown said it's Christ identifying himself in you. Amen. Praise God forevermore. Glory to God. God expressed himself through you, through his thoughts, by his words, his everything, expressing himself through you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Then, when that happens, you start becoming Christ-like. Is that right? Sometimes you're not even conscious that your nature is changed or changing. That you're not the man you used to be. That you're not the woman you used to be. And you, sometimes you even wonder at your own self. How come I'm not acting like I used to? You're supposed to get mad at a certain part, and instead of that, you're smiling or you're laid back. And you wonder, oh my goodness, I want to get angry and I can't even get angry. You start to get angry at yourself that you can't get angry. Can you imagine? Because the change is so powerful, God's power to transform.
Amen.
And it just creeps upon you. That's the beauty of the thing. It creeps upon you. It's not like you're here today, tomorrow, you say, oh, I feel a big change. Yeah. But the real change of God creeps upon you silently. Amen. It just happens. And before you know it, you're acting different, you're talking different, you're living different. Everything is different. Things are different now. The old song said, things are different now. Something happened to me since I gave my life to Jesus. Something happened. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord God. And we know that God has a threefold purpose. And that threefold purpose is now being fulfilled. Amen. And brother, sister, God did certain things and is doing certain things to fulfill his purposes. And we are some of the instruments that he is using for his glory. The first purpose that God had, Christ in the mission of God, you read the book, it says here, the first thing was that God wanted to reveal himself for people.
Amen.
Amen. God has accomplished that with me. Has he accomplished that in you?
Amen.
Has God accomplished that in you? He has revealed himself to a people, praise God, because why he had to reveal himself to a people? Because he's a spirit. And he first has to bring himself into word form. Right? And then, from word form, then he can go to be able to be in flesh again and manifest himself through human being. And the God who is a spirit, now God above us in the wilderness, God with us, as Jesus was with the disciples, now the hour is God in us.
Amen.
God in his people, empowering them, strengthening them. And he is the all in all. And now you understand what Paul was saying. His strength is made perfect in my weakness. Is that right?
Yes.
And through your weakness, people are able to see God. Or is he able to express himself? Like the, you don't take a picture with a frame and make them the same color because it just fades. Or put it on the wall where it fades into the wall and gets the picture. You have a little contrast on the frame. So his strength is made perfect in your weakness. The steps of a righteous man or ordained of the living God. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes, sir. Oh my. Praise God. So God wanted to reveal himself to a people so he can accomplish his secret. You say the secret. Yeah. But we know what the secret is. Because the secret had to be, you and I, had to be the bride. His wife. You see? As Adam had to have Eve apart from him taken out from him. Right? Praise God. Eve was taken out of Adam. And so God's secret was hiding the fact what he had displayed in Adam. That's exactly what he was going to do here on the earth. He was going to call out the people for his name.
Yeah.
Right? He was going to call out the people for his name, or to take his name. So he revealed himself through the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And make it clear and reveal to us that a part of himself, or a part of him who was the Word, was going to become his wife. Right? It was a part of Adam that became Eve.
Right.
And God is the Word. And it was a part of God that he had in his mind, secretly a part of the Word. In his mind, he took a part of himself and made that his wife. So he and her are made of the same material.
Amen.
Is that right? Praise God. Made of the same material. Glory to God. So we're happy tonight, today, that we are a part of him revealed. Right? We are not him because we can't reveal him because he is the fullness of that Godhead. Bodily. In the body back there, Jesus Christ, but now in this body. The Son of Man now being revealed in this hour. Praise the Lord. Oh, praise God. You may be a little tiny person, but you are connected to the God of the universe.
Amen.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
Praise God!
Hallelujah!
I don't fully understand it, but Brother Branham went beyond there and he understands it. That if you're connected to this God in the universe who is everywhere and all covers all space and all time, then if he will permit you, you can know anything. You can see anything. Anything can be revealed to you because you're connected to him. Well, we are only permitted to see what he wants us to see and know what he wants us to know.
Amen.
But we have access to his mind.
Right.
Is that right? We have access to his thoughts. Is that right? And from time to time, wife and husband are almost saying the same words at the same time. From time to time, before the husband speaks, she already sees what he has in his mind. Right? She sees what he has in his mind without them even uttering a word to one another. That begins to happen. That's what's happening to us now. You understand that? That's what is happening now. You're starting to get glimpses into God's mind, and therefore fulfills Brother Brad was saying, the bride has the word, and when she has the word, then she knows what to do with the word. Right? Because she knows what to do with the word. Praise the Lord. Even then, you have to stop when this is too much for you. I don't want to overfeed you and you leave here overfed or anything like that. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. So he was going to reveal himself through the word so he can get into a people. Right? Glory to God. Quote Brother Branham again here. Christ the mystery of God revealed. He said, he couldn't do it as the great Jehovah God who covered all space and time and eternity. He could not. He's too great to ever be revealed to people because it would be too mysterious. Hallelujah. Praise God. Wouldn't, even now it would be too mysterious if all of a sudden we are here in the building. The Holy Spirit descends. We can't see him. And all of a sudden, you're hearing a voice coming out of the air. Some of you say, oh, I would sit there and listen. No, most of you would run. Now be honest with yourself. We're in church now. You gotta be honest with yourself. You just heard a voice coming out of the air. You don't know what it is or who it is, whether it's the devil, whether it's Satan, whether it's God, what it is. It's too mysterious. That's what actually happened back in when Israel was in the wilderness and God came down in the spirit form on the Mount Sinai. Right. And being the great Jehovah covering all time and space, the mountain began to shake, the earth began to quake, everything began to move, the wind began to blow, and they could see fire on top of the mountain and smoke and everything else. And the people were so scared, some fell on the ground, others were running and everything else. And then God had to say, no, Moses, it's just, I can't do it this way. He says, you go down, now take these 10 commandments, go down there and you speak to them. And they said, who am I going to tell them? Am I going to go down and they're not going to believe me? He says, you go tell them, I am that I am. Sent you. Is that right?
Amen.
Little did he know that when he opened his mouth to tell Pharaoh, when Pharaoh asked him, who sent you? He wanted to tell him, the person who sent me is I am that I am. But he didn't say it like that. He just said, I am that I am. Why? Because God had gone into Moses.
Yeah.
Right? God had gone into Moses. And that's why he could speak pleasing to existence. Praise God. That's why he could call for frogs. That's why he could call for all his flies and everything else. Why? The Creator wasn't there.
Amen.
The Creator had gotten into Moses and was making himself expressed in that hour. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. And now in our day, the Holy Spirit got a hold of another man.
Amen.
Let every tree square up. Little fish, I give you your life. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Ask what you will, sister. Have you right? Amen. I'll give it to you right now. If you don't receive it, I'm a false prophet, thus saith the Lord. Amen. A lot of people hear that and they think that Brother Branham is saying, thus saith the Lord. This is the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. No, it was God speaking through him and saying, this is not Brother Branham speaking.
Amen.
This is the Lord. Thus saith the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. I've said it before on one in the days when we had the reel-to-reel tapes. I don't even know if they cut it out or if it's there anymore, because a lot of the tapes are shorter than they used to be with the preambulations, you know, Brother Brad talks and talks and talks. But in there, one of them, he was just talking like that, going along, all of a sudden you hear a voice broken. This is not William Branham speaking. This is the Lord God Almighty come down. William Branham has only loaned me his body and his voice. Thus saith the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And then the people screaming, shouting and all that. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's happened again in our day.
Yes.
a real prophet walked this earth and spoke the word, thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
Amen, Lord of God. And so God is expressing himself through the word.
Amen.
But you must understand that prophet has gone on and the word now has come down to us.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Now you understand the nonsense of the years gone by here, brothers preaching about the hour will come and we're going to go out there, we're going to speak this into existence. I mean, it's true, but not the way they were thinking. Like, you have the power, you have the authority to say, rain, go back. Storm, stand still. You do have that power, but not by self-will, but by his will.
Amen.
Praise God. It will be God expressing himself through you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit said, now that you know that you can't do it, speak to the stars. Tell it whatever you will. Speak to the sun. Tell it whatever you will. And Brother Brandon is nervous, but he said, storm, go back where you come from. All of a sudden, you heard the winds going, ooh, and it died right now. Sun, come out to shine. Watch the clouds go back, and the sun comes out to shine. He goes to the bottom of the mountain, and the people are saying, oh, a strange thing happened. We don't know what it was, but a storm started up. It was going to be a terrible storm. And then all of a sudden, the winds died down and the sun came out. He said, is that right? And then somebody kept talking. He says, you don't say. That's how he used to express himself. Amen. Because he knew what happened up on that mountain. But that has come back. And the same Spirit of God that was on Moses, that he was told to Moses, you can't do it alone. So from yourself, take that Spirit that is on you and place it on the 70 other men. 77 perfection. Pass it on to 70 other men and let them do it along with you. Fellow laborers along with you. Praise God. You believe that has happened in this hour?
Yes. Yes. Amen.
Praise God. That same Spirit that was on that prophet is now on an enterprise.
Amen.
God wants the user, praise God, not just expressing himself through the fivefold ministry,